so we can get in that order. All right, guys. So this is just kind of a little pre-summit. You know, all of us here are going to summit. So who's excited about summit? Are you at work, Candace?
Yes.
Oh, the Brigham. Oh, the Brigham.
Yep. OBS unit.
Oh, lovely. Super fun. Super fun. Well, awesome. Well, you know, I'm so excited. We're over here rocking the t-shirts for everybody to see. We decided to rock them. They're so nice. And I'm really excited about the colors. just grab me my charger. But yeah, I think everyone here, is pretty much, it's just Sophie's on this call, but I just kind of wanted to see what questions you guys had, and then just kind of, I mean, I'll probably say a lot of this kind of in person as well. But this week, you know, I guess what I'll probably say is that this is going to be a very crazy week. You're going to be inundated. You're going to be so excited. Like, it's going to be so exciting to finally be around all these other coaches, because like we talk about all the time, like, you know, this is such an isolating business at times, especially if you don't have a close network of coaches around you. And just like having someone that just to kind of run ideas off of, or just someone that you feel like, okay, at least I know I'm going on the right path, and, you know, I just need to just keep going. I need to keep, you know, doing what I'm doing, and eventually it'll come together, or one day the momentum's going to pick up more, or wherever we are in our business. And so the best advice I'll tell you, so first I'll say, you know, make sure I'm trying to think of just the overall tips. I will kind of say in terms of just like attire, so it's going to be hot. All the workshops are in an air-conditioned space. So make sure, you know how conventions are, it's like hot outside, but yet it's like 50 degrees inside. So make sure you kind of have at least a little sweater with you that you can at least carry with you. And then some of the activities will be outside. Like, I think obviously the main opening ceremony is at the stadium, and so that's outside. And then some of the other, I know the big workout on Saturday is outside, so that's going to be hot. But usually that workout's like at 6 o'clock in the morning. So it's pretty, you know, it's not going to be so hot. In terms of attire, a lot of people just wear very casual gear to the workshops. It's not like, you know, you're not trying to impress anybody with, what's that? Is that somebody's, can you lower that? Is there someone, whose phone is that? Is that mine? Who's beeping?
Oh, that's probably me. I'm not muted.
I was like, I'm like, who is beeping? I'm gonna mute everybody now. but where was I?
Not impressing everybody.
Attire. I know, but so basically it's gonna be hot. Indoors it's gonna be cold. A lot of activities are going to be outside. There's this like kind of country chic. I'll tell you right now, I'm not dressing really country chic. I'm just kind of wearing something that's comfortable for me. Look at Ashley. Ashley, you're going to wear, you're going to be country chic. Yeah. and I know Mandy's, you know, going, is having a ball over there shopping at the stores. But just dressing comfortably, light dresses, if you're a dress kind of girl, or, you know, shorts and something really comfortable. I figure we'll wear the shirts definitely for probably the big workout on Saturday, or, and then maybe one of the other indoor workouts if you guys are all going together collectively. Otherwise, you know, you're free to wear them whenever, but I just think it'll be nice to kind of wear them. And then a couple things, if you guys haven't had, like for your phones, it's those portable chargers that you can buy. Those are really good. I just got mine at Target for like $29. It's already too late to get the one from Amazon, but they're just nice to have because you're just going to want to take pictures, and you're going to be always on your phone to a certain extent. And so it's just going to really drain your battery. So making sure that you have that access, you know, just kind of that extra battery. What else? I think, so in terms of housing, so there's two houses. They are 0.8 mile apart from each other. So they're very close to each other. And both houses are about 2 to 2.8 miles, like roughly 2 to 2.5 miles away from the facility. So very close. You know, so if you ever decide you want to walk in the morning, that's very possible. You know, you can do that. If you want to drive, I think we'll be able to drive as well. There'll be plenty of us who have cars. I'm driving. I know a couple other people have cars. And so Amy will have a car. You know, Jess will have a car. Janine will have a car. So there's a lot of people with cars. And there's plenty of parking both at the both houses and at the on the street. The houses are pretty big. What'll happen is I'm going to put all of Sophie's, definitely all of Sophie and Sophie's downline definitely are all going to be in one house. In addition with like two to three from the rest of the team. Just because of how the houses are split. Overall, I think we're going to be very comfortable. I think there's enough bed space for eight and six, roughly. Enough so that leaves with like 13 or 14. And then we're going to have like two or three kind of air mattresses. And then we'll have this, and then there's couches on top of that. So I think we're going to have, and then one house will have three bathrooms. And then the other house will have two bathrooms. So I think that'll be very kind of, I think we'll all be fine. And I think we'll find out, we'll be very comfortable in both houses, I think. And then let me see what else. So some of the schedules you guys have seen, like Thursday is the opening ceremony, Thursday night. And then Friday and Saturday, they're going to be the workouts. In the morning, and then they're going to be workshops in the afternoon. And then Sunday, everybody leaves. Saturday night, there's a party, kind of like a goodbye celebration party. Friday night, there's going to be a, for people who qualify for the summit, for the Success Club party. And then I'm actually getting there on Tuesday. I'm actually staying at a hotel on Tuesday. So whoever's there Tuesday, let me know, because I'm planning on getting people together Tuesday night. So if I have a good idea of who's going to be there Tuesday night, I can get us together at a restaurant. I know Lee's also going, and Tamar, so we can get together Tuesday night. I'm staying at the hotel right across the street from the Music City Center or whatever. And then Wednesday, I'm going to go over to the house. We can check in at 3 o'clock on Wednesday. And then Wednesday night, we'll plan either something at one of our houses. I'm working with Jason Roberts and Kenna to try to get a lot of our teams together so that you guys can also interact with other coaches. You know, I will tell you, and I know Catherine and Sophie will tell you, like they'll kind of also kind of reiterate, is that super, you know, there's gonna be so many people there. Take advantage, you know, when you're online, when you're in between workshops, just talk to the person next to you. You know, don't be afraid. Even if you see someone that you've been following, like, people are very, very, very friendly. So don't be afraid to go up and say hello, or, you know, if you're standing online, just, you know, turning around and saying, hi, my name is Stephanie, you know, where are you from? And, you know, just really kind of starting that conversation, because that's where you really get to talk about ideas. You can think about a couple questions that you would like to kind of know. Like, I know I was always like, how do you run your challenge groups? Or like, you know, I'm curious, you know, how do you, you know, at every level, wherever you are, there's going to be certain things that you're struggling with. And so getting ideas of how other people run them will be very good as well. Another thing I would probably say is you're going to get so much information. You're going between all the workshops, everything that you're hearing, you bring a notebook with you. You can take notes. Also, all of these workshops will be recorded and they will be replayed, but usually takes about a couple weeks before they have the recording. I want you to be well aware and kind of prepared for when you leave Summit. You're going to be so excited and you're going to be like, oh my God, there's so, you know, you're going to have learned so much that it's going to, some people may get very overwhelmed with that feeling. And they may all of a sudden say like, oh my God, I don't know where to start. Or, oh my God, there's so much to kind of do. Or, oh my gosh, like, what am I going to, you know, what do I implement first? So know that that's a very common feeling, and prepare for that and kind of think about kind of on your drive back home, on your commute back home, you know, when you're talking to other people, think about things that you may want. You don't have to do everything all at once. You know, taking little things little by little and saying, okay, let me try this month. Let me try this, because you never know. You may try something and it may not work. Or you may try something and it does work, and you're never going to know unless you try. But I just don't want you guys to get paralyzed, because you're going to have so much information, and it's just going to, you're going to be very inspired. You're going to be like, I'm going to take over the world. Like, you know, you're going to like come out of this like super inspired, super motivated, which is why like I'm so excited so many of you are going. I don't know. Anyone, do you feel that way as well? Or Sophie, you know, oh, she's feeding her baby. Baby got to eat.
Prepare to have your minds blown is all I'm going to say. Like, yeah. You won't come out of Summit the same.
Yeah. I think for me, I've said it before, you know, for me, Summit is where I, at least for me personally, like I always knew it was a business, but I really fully didn't see the full potential of the business until I went to Summit. And I was just, it really made me take it just 10 times more seriously and really say like, this is a business. I need to treat it like a business. This is not a hobby, you know, and if I want to be my own, if I want to be the leader of my business and the CEO of my business, that comes with a certain discipline. It comes with a certain growth that needs to happen. And I guess, you know, I had not realized that until I went to Summit. Let me see what else. I talked about the houses a little bit. Everybody will have plenty of space. For people getting in Tuesday night, we're going to start meetups on Tuesday night, Wednesday night. Lots of potential to talk to other people. Another thing I wanted to bring up is the store. So when you know, Summit's going to have a store, and depending on when you go, there might be a big line. I don't know how they're going to do it. I'm very curious to see how they're going to do it this year, because there's going to be a lot of us there, and I'm curious to see how they're going to handle the crowd. But one piece of advice I will tell you is that if you see something that you like, you need to buy it. Do not hesitate, because it will sell out, and it will not be there 2 hours later when you go back. So if you see something and it's in your size and you're like, oh, I really want that, you know, just buy it, because you know, the things that probably won't sell out, you know, are like the ugly things that like nobody wants. And so all the nice, really cool stuff, and you're like, oh, that's really nice. You know, everybody look like our t-shirts are really awesome. So, you know, you're going to want to buy it. And even by the time we even get to it, sometimes I remember there was stuff already sold out by like the first afternoon. So, you know, I remember there was like these elite shakers, these shaker cups that everybody seemed to have, that all the elite people had, because the elite coaches get to go in first on like a day before and get to like buy whatever they want. And so just that would be my best piece of advice, you know. So you're going to have, size is going to be available. All the new supplements are going to be available. And so just make sure, you know, you come budgeted, you know, if you're going to buy it, come budget for, you know, budgeted for it. Let me see. Oh yeah, there's
the
app.
Store.
Huh?
The store also only takes cards, which like I usually pay for stuff with cash, so I read that it only takes debit cards. So that people know that. That's all.
Good to know. I didn't realize that. That's really good to know. I did not realize that. People were asking about, in terms of just going back to the housing. So there's going to be most linen for all the beds and everything. I would just, you know, I'm assuming they're going to have towels, but I would just bring a towel just in case, you never know. People were asking about the workouts. So the workouts, depending on, it depends. So like I said, we're about 2 miles away from the facility. So you just kind of have to budget. If you have an early morning workout, you know, coming back, like if you know, you just have to kind of, like I know last year I didn't have time to go back home and shower after the workout. I kind of just wore my workout gear the whole time throughout through the workshops. And then I remember Sophie had like, you know, I don't think any of us went back and showered. But let me see what else. Any other questions right now as I'm kind of going and mumbling, but, or any concerns or just pure excitement or anything that you're nervous about? Probably not. I don't think there's anything to be nervous about. just more excited about. You know, it's going to be great for all of you guys to meet each other. I'm trying to think. Anything, any other tips, Luke or Sophie, that, or?
How are we doing food?
Ah, that's a good question. Okay, food. So, food. So I'm happy to, I think if you guys, I feel like if you're driving, you know, consider bringing something so you have snacks. You know, for me, I was planning on maybe going and buying a bunch of fruit and like, because what'll happen is that you're going to be at the location all day. And so I bought like some protein bars that I really like. You're going to have your Shakeology. I was thinking of just making like sandwiches and just bringing sandwiches with me and just having them. And then that would be kind of like my food. And then dinner, we can either, you know, depending on what we're doing that evening, we can either, you know, buy food and make it. I don't know. I haven't thought that far in advance, but I don't know if you guys have ideas of what we can do. We can either... No, Luke is not cooking, he said. So, just for Jessica right there. Luke, you gotta make some penne vodka or something, you know, some, or, you know, or we can order in, or we can, I think we'll figure something out. Where the houses are, there's other little restaurants around there too as well. And so, let me see, Jessica, go ahead.
So the bag restriction was lifted, right? So we can bring coolers. The bag restriction was lifted?
Yes.
So we can bring coolers and all that good stuff.
Can we bring, I guess you could bring like, I don't think you can, I don't, I guess so. I don't see, like.
I mean, worst case scenario, we can leave it in the car though, right?
Yeah.
But we can bring bags with changes of clothes and things like that.
What I did last year was I put like a day bag and I put it in my car and it has like an insulated, like a big insulated bag cooler. It wasn't huge. So I took like my insulated bag into the session so I could eat. But then I had like the extra stuff that I didn't necessarily need in the stadium or the sessions with me. I just left that in the car. So since there's so many of us driving, I think that's easy. We can all kind of leave the extra stuff that we want access to if we need it in the car. And then I didn't take like I said, it wasn't a big cooler, but it was like one of those insulated bags. It's kind of like a big purse almost. And that was more than enough for me.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. I don't know how big the cooler is going to be, but there are like an FAQ or rules of regulation on how big of a bag you can bring in the stadium. That's why they had that rule with a clear bag. So you need to let people know that maybe they might not be able to bring that cooler.
Oh, I don't know. Luke is saying he's not sure if there's like a restriction to the size of the bag, but I don't know if anyone's seen that. I know that they, I just know that they lifted that. It doesn't have to be clear.
If I find it, I'll just post it for everybody else.
Luke said if he finds anything, he'll post it and let us know.
I saw someone said something about we can't wear heels like
yes.
to the right. event. Or to what can we not wear heels to?
You can't wear heels into the stadium.
So who wants to wear heels into the stadium?
Well, you can't wear heels, you know, for this. It's for, I think, on the field, you can't wear heels. They're saying, I feel
like that's where the party is. The last party.
Is it?
There a party on the field?
I think it might be.
Oh.
I think that's why they're referring to heels, because that's the only thing I can imagine where we want to wear heels. So.
I have to double check that, because I'm not sure if the party is, yes, absolutely, you cannot wear heels, you can wear wedges and flats. And I'm assuming because it's the field, I'm not sure where the party is on Saturday night. If it's true that it's on the field, then yes, you will not be able to wear heels and you can wear wedges and sit in flats. I don't wear heels that much, so it doesn't matter to me either way, but I really like to wear heels.
Right. I was like, who's wearing heels to the sessions? Weirdos.
Well, I know I'm not, so. But some people like to wear heels on the regular. Let's see, what else? Any other questions or concerns? Or how's everyone else, is everyone, you know, how's everyone going into some, you know, and then plan on, like, really taking advantage of being there and posting a lot. Like, I mean, already it's already started. Like, I feel like I'm posting so much already. But it's just going to, you know, it's just, again, it's all about momentum. It's all about people seeing the excitement and the team and just kind of the camaraderie and the friendships. And because remember, a lot of people become a part of our network, not really, you know, a lot of them, they want to be a part of something and they want to feel, you know, they want to feel that same the same positive spirit that you're going to feel this week. A lot of people, you know, want to feel that as well. And so the more that you post and you take advantage and, you know, commit to posting all the time, you know, throughout your sessions, that'll really help you. Let's see. Anything else? Is anyone getting there Thursday? No, everyone will be there Wednesday for the most part. Thursday. Okay. Cool. Good. It'll be fun. It'll be a good time. It will be a good time. Let's see. Any other questions, concerns, thoughts? So, nothing else?
Nothing I can think of.
Sophie, anything you can think of?
Just getting ready to, like she said, for me, this is when I, like, we all, like, want to believe in this business, and we have this passion for it. The time that I got, like, a breakthrough and clarity as to how to do it, not just wanting to do it, but I was like, oh, this is how you do it, and that gave me even more passion, so I think that'll be huge for everybody. Last year, it was in June, and then coming out of it, July was my highest paid month ever, my most successful month, so obviously, I've surpassed that now, but that was what broke me through. So I'm just so excited for all of you. I'm so proud because we all know what it took to make this trip happen. We all know that it could have been so easy to say, I can't, I have kids, I have work, I have all these other things. So we all know the sacrifices that we made, and I'm just really proud of our team.
Yeah. Yeah, I think out of our downline, we're probably one of the bigger teams in terms of representation. So that's, like Sophie said, it's like, I definitely appreciate it because I can't, you know, Sophie, myself, Catherine, we can't recreate this experience for you in any shape or form. And so that, I think that's why I'm more excited for you guys going because, you know, you know how it is. There's ups and downs in this business. There's times when you're like, man, I want to give up. There are times when you're like, can I do this? Is this worth it? Is this, and I can't, as much as I'm gung-ho about it, I can't recreate the experience of being there and seeing everybody and realizing, I think more so that you're not alone and that everyone has the same struggles as you do. Everyone who's up there as a top 10 coach, who's making, you know, hundreds of thousands of dollars, you know, they all started where, you know, where all of you started and where all of, you know, where we all start. And that experience, like anything, you know, that experience is priceless and it will help you through the harder times because there's going to be continued ups and downs. It doesn't mean after this, it's not going to be no down points and no times when you're going to struggle through. But I do know for a fact that every single time I've come together with a bunch of coaches, I always come back revived a little bit and just kind of a little bit more motivated, a little bit more focused, a little bit more like this is going to happen, you know, however it's going to happen, it'll happen. And you get validated. You get validated with all the work. Cause at the end of the day, when you're working this hard, sometimes we just need validation just to know that whatever I'm doing, even if it seems like it's not working, at least I know I'm doing the right thing. And you need that validation. And you know, you can get it from me, from Luke, from Catherine, from Sophie, but it's like to get it from other people too. And I just think that's even better. I just think that's an even stronger kind of powerful message. And I'm just excited. I'm so, so excited because Beachwide does a really good job of just getting us excited and putting on a good welcome celebration. And, you know, so it'll be, and also reminding your downline, you know, message your personally sponsored coaches, letting them know that on Thursday they can watch the opening ceremony live and they can do the workout on Saturday morning live. So, you know, for all the coaches who can't be there, it'll be really nice for them at least to see the opening ceremony. Cause like I said, Beachbody usually does a really nice job of just kind of the speakers and seeing all the coaches who walk across for their recognition. I'll be walking across on stage, so that'll be really exciting. So just kind of, it'll be just fun. It'll be fun.
One tip that a coach shared last year in one of the seminars I went to was, you know, we're going to be posting and whatnot about the excitement of Summit, but we still have groups that are ongoing. A lot of us, we have challengers, and they made the point to, even though you think you're going to maybe be able to keep up with the groups, just go ahead and put someone in place, either one of your downline coaches or one of your star challengers, and just ask them before you ever leave for Summit, ask them to kind of fill in the gap and like take the lead in the group, you know, post more often or tag people and check in on them. Essentially ask someone to step up as a leader while you're gone, just so that the group momentum doesn't fall off and people don't feel like you abandoned them, because this is still our jobs. And so just secure that before you go to Summit, that way in case you do get really busy, because these days are, they're long and they're so busy, and you're going to come out of this like, I need a week of sleep. This is like, you don't sleep while you're there. So just go ahead and cover yourself and make sure your groups are still taken care of while you're gone.
And I want to reiterate that they're very long days. I think I remember being up, you know, especially that we're going to be all together. It's going to be long days, in a good way. You're just going to be so excited. You're going to get up. The workouts are in the morning. You go right to the workshops all day. There's evening events. And then you're going to come home and you're going to bond and talk. And then you're going to like literally fall asleep out of exhaustion and then then wake up again the next morning. And so it's definitely, they're really long days. I definitely remember that, just being exhausted. I mean, to the point where I didn't even make the super workout last year. I was like, this is way too. It was like 5 o'clock in the morning. I was like, I am not going to that workout at 5 o'clock in the morning. So, you know, all my early, so I'll go this year, but I was just like, it's just long days. So cool. Amy.
I just thought of something. Fixate and Size are both launching while we're at Summit, right?
And the supplements. And they surprised us last year with 3-day refresh.
So okay.
That's true. What will be this year.
So we should probably like have our scripts and everything all ready and on our phones for that if we want to try to do that during Summit. Okay.
You should be, you know, ideally today, tomorrow, posting about Size, posting about your next group, just saying super excited, maybe posting a video of you doing the workout. What will be awesome is if we can get a video of all of us like doing the workout, you know, together, you know, this upcoming week on Wednesday night or Thursday or something, just to kind of really promote. Lucas shaking his head. He always has something to say.
He can film it.
He's getting certified in Size.
Yes, Luke is
on
getting
Wednesday.
I think
on Tuesday.
Wednesday. I see you, Lottie. One second. I'm just let me see. I think what was I saying? So yeah, so just make sure you're starting to promote it. Just because when it drops, then you can at least have the, you know, you'll have the links and you'll be able to send it to people. And I definitely know it's $140 with Shakeology. And then the Fixate and all that. So I would definitely start talking to people about it.
Sounds good.
Lonnie.
Hey, everybody.
Hey.
I just wanted to let you know that Ben is not looking forward to doing anything has to do with Size. So he could be the perfect videographer. I'm not dancing in front of a bunch of people.
Luke said he may have to fight him.
Luke says he's going to have to fight you. He don't want to do anything.
Luke will do it. He'll do it.
Anyway, so yeah, I was just volunteering him without his consent.
Awesome, awesome. Anyone else? Ashley, you're getting there on Tuesday.
But I have a baby running around and Joe talking, so. What was the question?
I said, are you getting there on Tuesday?
I am, yes.
Oh, okay, awesome.
Yeah, I'll be there early Tuesday, and I don't remember the hotel I'm staying at. I don't know how the hell I'm going to get from there to where I need to do my turbo. I don't have a clue. I'm the worst traveler ever. I don't have a clue. So I figure I'm just going to have to go online and look at it all and figure it out. I'm not sure.
We'll figure it out.
Yeah.
Awesome. Are there any other questions? Otherwise, you know, I know it's, I don't want to keep you guys. Anything else? Oh, Candace.
Quick question. I had to drop off and give meds, but quick question. You may have said this already. Do you know when you're going to let us know where the house is so we have directions and all that good stuff?
Yes. I'll message you guys and give you guys the list of where staying, who's staying, like where everyone is staying. Like I said, definitely all of Sophie's team is going to be together. And then there's going to be about probably three more people from the team in that house. And then the rest are going to be in the second house. So it's going to be pretty evenly split amongst the two. So the houses again are only 0.8 mile away from each other. And then they're about 2 miles away from where we need to be for the facilities, like for the event.
Okay. So we're not like by Monday or what have you. Okay.
Yes.
And should we just plan on bringing an air mattress or?
If you have an air mattress, I would bring it.
Okay.
I would bring it. I have a queen. I know Maisha's bringing a twin. And then I think Kristen said she had one. Someone else said they had a queen that they were going to bring. And then, so I would just bring it just in case. And then just bring like a sheet for it just in case.
Okay. All right, cool.
Bring it because even though I don't have a mattress, air mattress, I'm more than happy to sleep on it. So even if you bring it, don't feel like you'll have to be the one to sleep on it. I'm happy to sleep on one. I just don't have one to bring.
Sounds good. Hi, Kari.
She's so cute.
Hi, Kari. I'm sorry. I always have to say hello to Kari. Hi, Kari.
Kari, say hi.
Hi.
Too cute. All right, guys. Well, I'm so excited, and I'll be bringing your shirts. And, you know, if you haven't paid me, you can pay me there. It's no problem. And I'm very excited. I'm very excited to see all of you and to hug all of you and to have a good time. Maisha?
Hey, I don't want to keep anyone if anyone has to go, but I guess I was thinking about this the whole entire time we were talking. I have no idea how to plan for food for this. Am I like the only one that's thinking like that? We can talk offline if you wanted to, but besides Shakeology, I don't know what else to bring.
I was planning on probably doing like, I bought some protein bars, and then I was going to, most likely knowing me, I would do sandwiches. So I would buy lunch meat. I would buy sliced bread, get some ham and turkey and then fruit, and then just do sandwich kind of galore is what I would probably do. Personally, it's not like I'm going to be bringing salads and prepared food. And then in the evening, that's where we just have to figure out, I think, what we're going to do in the evening, whether we decide to try to make something at the houses and just have like a big dinner big dinner on Wednesday. Cause basically I'm getting there Tuesday night. So depending on whatever night you go. So Tuesday night, I'm going out to eat. Wednesday night, is where basically we just have to decide if we want to cook at home, which is fine. It's a full, I mean, the kitchens are fully decked with pots, pans, everything. We would just need to buy everything. And then Thursday night, the same thing, and Friday. So it's just like, we just have to decide kind of as a group, if we want to cook something, if we want to go out to eat, if we want to order in, that's also an option. You know, it doesn't have to be, or if people just want to do their own thing, I'm happy to cook, have something that we prepare, and do it that way. Luke's looking at me like, who's going to be doing the cooking? But, you know, there's a lot of food that we can do in bulk, but I know for the actual day, fruit bars, and I'm trying to think of like Tony Robbins. Like when I went to Tony Robbins, like, go ahead, Sophie.
I was going to say last year, the kind of like, there are going to be places around that you can get in line and order like food from a concession stand, but the lines are going to be absurd. And if personally, that gave me an anxiety attack and just made me angry to have to wait in line for food that was so shitty anyway. So this is the kind of stuff, it's like what she said, like, even if you're not driving to Nashville, so many of us are. So we will be able to go to the grocery store and stock up and keep stuff in our fridges, and then you can pack your lunch for the day. The kind of stuff I packed, like you said, sandwiches. Basically what I did was I walked through the store and went, what can I eat with my hands? What do I not need to be like super fancy with? So I got like a thing of peanut butter and some like baby carrots, and I got like cottage cheese and tomatoes, like just simple things that I could just like be a rando and sit on the floor and eat while I was waiting in line for something. And so don't get too nervous about it, because it's basically like finger foods essentially. What else was I gonna say? If we could do this in Vegas, we would be able to do this in Nashville, because Vegas is not like lifestyle, you know, friendly.
Okay.
Yeah.
I know. I'll be driving, by the way, and I'll be driving by myself, so I'll have a lot of space in my car.
Yeah. I think just like I think what I was planning on doing was like Sophie said, just sandwiches, fruits, vegetables, cut up vegetables, things that I can easily just not have to heat up and just grab. So, like, think of like going to like an amusement park or like a lunch, like a camp or something, and you're just trying to figure out something you can eat that you'll enjoy eating at least, you know, throughout the day. And then dinner, again, we'll just have to figure out, and we can talk via the messenger dinner what we want to do, and I'm happy to go either way in terms of just collectively, you know, because we can always just go to Costco and we can, you know, bake food, or it all depends. I'm just trying to think. Yeah. And it also depends on what we're going to do for the meetups, and if we're going to go away for the meetups, if the meetups are just going to be at our house. Again, I'm waiting to hear from Jason and Kenna to see if they're going to come to our house. I know Kenna's doing a lot of stuff at her house, and Lee's going to be with Kenna at least for a little bit. I'm sure she'll come out. If we end up doing this stuff at our house, I'm sure she'll come out to us as well. But yeah.
Okay, because I'm thinking, do I have to like boil a whole dozen of eggs?
No,
don't even bring a blender. I'm thinking so complex. I'm like, it can't be this hard.
No. And for what it's worth, I was thinking of bringing my blender just in case. So I'm pretty sure they're all, it's like when I was looking at the stuff for the house, everything, it's fully, you know, the kitchens are fully furnished just in the rest of the house.
Okay.
Janine?
I have my blender.
Oh, good.
So we're
have your blender.
My cheap blender, yeah.
So we'll have plenty of blenders. But yeah. Cool. It'll be exciting. And like I said, there's plenty of little restaurants around where we are too. Like little supposedly. I've never been to Nashville, so I have no idea what to. I don't know what around means. I mean, I know around means within the Huh?
Nashville is like the cutest, it's just the cutest little, it's like a big city, but it like small town. It's very small town, super cute, super trendy. You guys are gonna love it. I don't know how 25,000 of us are gonna go there, but that's like one of my favorite places to visit.
It'll be exciting. And one of the houses, if not both the houses, has a huge backyard, plenty of little like nooks and crannies to just like sit around and talk. And one of them has like a rocking, you know, like a rocking seat in the front porch, and just like, it's really, you know, a wraparound porch, and just like really, really nice. So, you know, it's going to be a very, and like I said, again, plenty of space in both homes. They're actually pretty big, both homes. So I think I'm really happy that it worked out, because I think everyone's going to feel really comfortable, and everyone's going to have a really good time and just be very excited and just, you know, endure the humidity and the heat, which some of us are already used to down here living in the Southeast. So, and in the, you know, in the South. So, because it was hot today here in Florida. Awesome. Great. Anything else? Cool. So we'll see each other soon. We'll see each other on Wednesday. Woo! Look at Sophie. Woo!
No, yeah. Break it down.
Look at Kari. Yay! Awesome. All right, guys. Well, safe travels, and obviously stay connected via the via, you know, we'll have the we'll have the messenger and you guys, and we'll be texting, but the messenger, I'll have my phone on me all the time like I normally do. So I am never without my phone. So you guys can always reach me and I'll be available. And again, Wednesday we get access to the house at 3. So just know that at 3. So, oh, awesome. But cool. It'll be exciting. All right, guys. Well, have a good night and get ready for an amazing week. Bye.